This is a very unique technology. Is a balloon with a stent, and so far nothing unique. But the unique of this technology that the polymer and the drug to prevent restenosis are positioned not only on the stent but on the balloon as well, and they are positioned only abluminal, which means towards the wall of the vessel and not towards the wall, the lumen of the vessel. So having the polymer and the drug placed on the balloon and on the stent, you will have a very homogeneous and complete delivery of the drug, in this case sirolimus, on the wall of the vessel. The potential is to be able to treat patients or lesions which are notorious, more aggressive in terms of restenosis. And one group of patients we are devoting our interest to are diabetics. I think we know that diabetics have a higher late loss after stent implantation, more intimal hyperplasia, and the idea behind this formulation is that if you deliver the drug in a more homogeneous fashion, you will improve the efficacy, and we will have a better favorable late loss and an advantage in this population. Luca Testa, another interventional cardiologist, presented some preliminary data supporting what I just said, but I think the goal will be to demonstrate in a randomized study what was presented as hypothesis generating. We are planning to conduct a more strong hypothesis generating, because it's still not a pivotal study, but still will be a very important study which will randomize 140 patients evaluating these abluminal polymer balloon and stent versus the XIENCE, which is the so-called gold standard drug-eluting stent in a diabetic population, and the primary goal will be to evaluate the intimal hyperplasia by optical coherence tomography at follow-up angiography. If we can demonstrate that we really have an impact in lowering the late loss, the intimal hyperplasia, comparing to XIENCE, I believe we have a solid ground to do a more definite clinical study. The key clinical question is going to be that this stent platform with the balloon platform, because they are two together, may become a gold standard device for diabetic patients.